So, we just had the announcement of iOS 16, and it comes with lots of new features, including the ability to add widgets to your lock screen and also have the ability to do photo sharing, to name a few. However, today I'm going to show you how to install iOS 16 for free on your iPhone, just like what I've done onto this iPhone XS right here. And best of all, you do not need a developer's account for this. Now, just quickly, a disclaimer. iOS 16 is in its developer beta stage, so this does mean there are still quite a few bugs and bits and pieces that need to be fixed with iOS 16 at the time I am making this video. So if you do want to install iOS 16, be warned that there could be some bugs out there and it is a developer's beta. So, you know, what I'd recommend doing before upgrading to iOS 16 is definitely doing a backup on your phone, what I'm going to show you in a second. And also, if you do have a secondary iPhone lying around, what is eligible, like I have here with this iPhone XS that I've been using, basically I would recommend installing this onto this device instead of your primary device. If you do want to install it onto your primary device, that is up to you to do that, but I'm not responsible that if any apps are not going to be working or there are bugs and things that need to be sorted out. Now, with that out of the way, guys, let me show you how to install iOS 16. So how I got my iPhone XS onto iOS 16, I still had to be on iOS 15 to begin with. And also what I needed to do was a full backup of my iPhone, just in case I ever wanted to revert back to iOS 15. To do this, we've got to go to settings, we've got to go into our account, and then what we need to do after this is go into iCloud, and then into this, we need to go into iCloud backup. And the best thing to do is backup now. So all you need to do is just basically press on this and it will do a complete backup for you. Now, depending how regularly you backup or how large your backup is, depends on how long this will actually take. So this shouldn't take too long to complete, so I'll just fast forward this a little bit. Once this is complete, we want to go back out, and then we want to go back to general, and then we just want to make sure that our iPhone's on the latest version of iOS. So right now this is iOS 15.5 at the time of making this video. After this, we want to come back out, completely come out of settings, and now we can begin with the installation of iOS 16. Now, to do this, you need to do this through Safari. You cannot do through it through Chrome or any other browser. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to adjust my phone here. And what we need to do is open up Safari, and then what we need to do is open up a search and type in iOS beta profile, or even just type in beta profile, it doesn't matter, either one, iOS beta profile or just beta profile. After this, what we want to do is just to do a search for this. I'm just going to select this top one here, and it should be betaprofiles.com, as you can see on the top. So I'm just going to click onto this. Now, you might get a few ads and bits and pieces like this, so just ignore these, but you want to scroll down until you see iOS 16, and it's the beta profile. And what we want to do is we want to click onto this install profile. So I'm just going to do that now, and then you'll get this message, and all you just need to do, just ignore basically all of this. It's saying to back up your phone and everything. We've done all of that, but all we need to do is just click on install anyways. So once this happens, we'll get this message to download something. So we're just going to click allow, and basically there we go. It says the profile is downloaded. So we can close this down, and to be honest, we can just leave this web page now, so we can completely close down Safari because we don't need this at all. What we want to do is go back into settings, and we want to go near to the top here, and basically we want to get the more information about your iPhone. I've got a few other messages, but you can see at the bottom it says profile downloaded. We're going to click view profile, and there we go. It says here iOS 16 beta software profile, and all we want to do is click on the install at the top, and what you want to do is put in your passcode. So I'm just going to do this. And once complete, you'll get basically some terms, conditions and everything like that if you want to have a good read through them. But just click on install at the top, click install again, and then basically it will tell you to restart your phone. So you just want to press restart, and now your phone will restart to basically apply the kind of sort of beta profile onto it. The beta isn't installed yet, but it's just applying kind of the beta profile onto the phone. So I'm just going to fast forward this to the main screen. And my phone has restarted, and I've unlocked it again back onto the main home page. So what we need to do after this, just wait for you to connect back to Wi-Fi, because you'll definitely need Wi-Fi for this download. So I'm just going to leave a couple of seconds. Go into settings again, but this time go to general, and we're going to go to software update again. But this time, as you will see, voila, iOS 16 developer beta. So what we want to do is click download and install. So I'm just going to put my code in again. And after putting in your code, basically the download will begin, and we just need to accept the terms and conditions again. Just click agree on this and agree one more time. And basically it's going to update requested, as you can see here. So it's waiting for the download to come along. And to be honest, this is the main part of the waiting game now. Actually, this part actually probably takes longer than to install actually iOS 16. So as you can see, it does say about 2 minutes remaining to complete. So I'm just going to fast forward this because there is a validation part and also getting the update ready part. So let me just skip to that. So there we go, it says preparing update. And now this bit may take some time to complete. It can take anywhere between 15 minutes to an hour to complete. So once this is completed, you'll get a message that basically says to install now. So we're ready to actually do the full update. So you can see that at the bottom. So what I'm just going to do is just press install now, and this will actually start everything now. So like, here we go, this is the verifying update bit I was talking about. So this will just take a minute or two to complete. And now what will happen is your phone should start to shut down and start to restart again. Don't worry if your screen turns off and on again and you get the Apple logo. There's nothing to worry about here. This is absolutely normal, and you've just got to let this install. So just quickly, as iOS 16 is installing onto the iPhone or onto your iPhone right now, I want to talk about the channel giveaway that I'm doing right now. And it is for this. This is for a MacBook Air M1. Now I know we do have the new MacBook Air M2, and yeah, it is really, really cool, but would you love to get your hands on a brand new MacBook Air? Well, this one here is the 512GB option, and it also is the 8-core GPU option as well. And I'm gonna be giving this away to one lucky subscriber when we get over 400,000 subscribers. And to be honest, if you look at the subscribers right now, we're not that far away. All you have to do to enter into this international giveaway is put down in the comments below if you plan to buy any technology gear or Apple gear in 2022. Let me know what it is in the comments below. And like I said, when we get over 400,000 subscribers, I'm going to be creating a video announcing who the winner is of this MacBook Air. Now with that, just very quickly, I just want to say there are a lot of scammers and spammers out there, even quite a lot of them impersonating myself right now, telling you to basically Telegram them, WhatsApp them, all sorts. Ignore them completely. This is not me. Like I said, I'll be creating a video only when we get over 400,000 subscribers, and I won't be sending out messages saying like that what other people have been doing with scammers and things. So just ignore them, or please do report them, because they're really, really getting on a lot of people's nerves here on lots of other channels as well. But with that out of the way, guys, let's go back to the iPhone and let's have a look, see how iOS 16 is installing. So this whole process may take around about half an hour to fully complete to install iOS 16. But once it is fully installed, what should happen is you should get to the main home page, as you can see here. And I'm just going to swipe up to come into it. Put my code in again very quickly. And as you can see here, it says the software update has been completed to iOS 16. So it means it's been successful. I'm going to click continue here, and it might take a second or so just to load the next thing. It's telling me to set up my wallet. I'm going to do this a bit later on, but you can set this up. It's the same procedure like in iOS 15. And this may take a minute or two just to completely load, so don't worry about that. But we get the usual messages about iPhone analytics. Just going to click continue on this, and that we're going to share those app developer details. And there we go. Welcome to iPhone. Now, the best way how you can tell if it's worked or not. Oh, I'm just going to say we haven't set up my data. Oh, and also that we got spatial audio. So that's new. That's one way how you know you're on iOS 16. But I'm just going to click dot dot now. But it's at the very bottom here, just above the main dock. You can see there is an actual search bar. It says search. And this used to be on the left, but as you can see, I can just start typing in things. I'm going to type in the weather, for example, now. And there we go. The weather app's appeared just like before. So that's fully working and everything like that's really, really cool. So we know straight away we're on it. I'm just going to show another feature. I'm going to go into settings here. Let's fiddle around with that new wallpaper setting. I just can't see it now. Where is it? Oh, there it is, wallpaper. And I'm going to click add new wallpaper. And as you can see, it's all changed here. We've got the new wallpaper settings. So I'm just going to click on this color one here. And yeah, let's have a look. I can change my sort of way I want my colors. So I'm going to leave it on, I don't know, vapor bright. Yeah, let's leave it on bright. And then what I can do is I can add my widgets on now. So let's see, I'm going to add on, still got the Apple Pay. I'm going to add the weather widget on, and also I'm going to add on my batteries for like my AirPods Max. I think that'd be really cool. So I'm just going to get rid of that. Let's see what else we can do. Let's do my fitness as well. I've got this on my watch, but I've always wanted it on my phone on the main screen. That's really cool now that we can have this. So it's really easy just to add those widgets onto the screen, as you can see. I'm not too sure if I'm a big fan of this font, to be honest, on the clock, so I might just change that. So let's just click on that. Let's change it to a different font. Let's try that one. Oh, okay, nah, not that one. That one looks pretty cool, to be fair. Yeah, I like that. And then we can actually just change the weather and bits of the widgets here if I wanted to do so. But to be honest, I'm happy with the weather. So I really, really like that. So yeah, I really like my new home screen. In fact, actually, no, let's change the color. Let's actually, yeah, because I don't really know if the pink works. Try this. No, slider wasn't working there. So there we go, there's a bug. But let's have it as a green there, kind of a white sort of color, semi-green. Yeah, I'm happy with that. Let's click done. And there we go. So I'm just going to come out of this completely. And let me just turn off the screen and let me just turn it back on again. And there we go, all working. And that is how easy it is to install iOS 16 or the beta developer's iOS 16 onto your iPhone for absolutely free without a developer's profile. So as you can see, it was really easy to install iOS 16 beta onto an iPhone if your iPhone is eligible to have it. And to be honest, it's really, really cool with some of the features that we have here. Just like with that lock screen I just showed you guys, it's really, really cool. But guys, with this, it's also time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And also at the same time, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews, and comparison, please make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell. Until next time, guys, I will see you really soon. Take care now. Bye bye.